afternoon, YouTube land. Thank you so very much for spending just a couple of your precious moments in time as we just praise His holy name. We're going to praise His holy name together because we know, we, that means you and me, we know where we were. And we know what the Lord has personally brought us through. And when you know that, it doesn't matter what's going on in the fake news world. And it doesn't matter if you're just not up to date with what's going on, because if you're like me, it's just a circus. It is a three-ring circus. I just, some of the things I see, I'm just like, are you kidding me? Are you serious? It's devastating. It is devastating. That's why I can't help but praise His holy name. I was watching the news, and this was a couple of days ago, and it was actually a special broadcast on what's going on in the community and around the world and, whatever. And I just was clueless that there are so many people dealing with Alzheimer's. And so it takes its toll not only on the person with the Alzheimer's disease, but it also takes a toll on the caregivers, whether it's family or the nurses or, whoever's caring for you. And so this is what the program was about. How immediate family members, like let's say a son is given care and the authorization to watch over and look out for his mom with Alzheimer's. And so after doing this for a couple of years, it just, of course it's gonna put a strain on his life because it's not his life anymore. It's his mother's life, and then it's his life. So it's like he's juggling the responsibility of caring for an aging mother versus go, you know what I mean? So anyways, moving right along so I don't bore people. I know, I just can't believe this. They put him in a car and then, they're like at their wits' end and they drive him to the hospital, like the emergency room area, and they like curb him. It's like they, without sounding horrible, they literally kick him out and leave their, mentally disabled, like I don't even know what day of the week it is, and they just drop him off at the hospital, knowing that the staff in the hospital can't turn their backs on. But isn't, oh my gosh, that is so mean. And it's happening. I couldn't believe it. I was like, who in their right mind would do that to grandma or mom or pops? I mean, and then I started looking at the things that I've been going through lately. And, I mean, I have to tell you, I have been going through similar things, and if it wasn't for my love and for my knowing that, I don't have all the answers for life, but he does, and that's fine with me. Thank God. Thank God even more for that. Another thing that I want to bring to your attention is this climate change, this global climate chaos, and yes, it is chaotic. When there's cornfields, there's not gonna be any corn. And And now that there was this deep freeze up in the northern parts of the US of A, and I saw with my very own eyes cattle. I mean, we're talking cows, we're talking other animals like deer, and I forget, there was another species, but I forget what it was. But they were frozen. And they weren't even like cut up in bits. They were frozen animals. I mean, it just doesn't get any more. You just look at what's happening in the world and you're just, what's going on? Jesus is coming back one of these days. One of these days. And I know I want to be ready. And I haven't been. And the Bible even says if you're not hot for the Lord, you're lukewarm or you're cold. You could be cold as ice. And that's why I'm telling you, we need to praise his holy name. We are living in days that, I mean, I don't even, sometimes I'm, dementiated Donna over here. I don't know. I know it's been a while since I made a video. I know that much. And I know I'm still thanking the Lord for yesterday and for today. And I thank God for you because, without you guys being out there on the other side of the computer, we believe in a higher power and we know where we get our strength from. And we know that everything moves and speaks and lives and has its being because of Him. And a lot of people don't understand that. They don't want to know about it. They actually reject that. And I wrote this thing down, but you know what? It's in the other room because I didn't bring it in here. But it says it's better to know him and to accept him and then to find out that he is than to claim that he is not and then find out that, you know what, after it's all said and done, he really is. And I can't even repeat that for you because that was one of those things where you just have to like read it and it gets stuck in your head. But then, if you try and remember it again, it's not going to work. Know. What is going on? Praise his holy name again this day. So, that's all I wanted to say. I know the message is short and sweet because that's just how it is. God is so loving and so patient and so omniscient and so everywhere all at once, and He loves us. He does. And He does. And He doesn't stop. And I like that about the Lord. Because you know what? Sometimes I am lukewarm, and I feel like I got spit out of someone's mouth sometimes, you know? That's when you just don't want to get out of bed. I just can't do it. Everything in your body hurts. Thank God for loving us and for His strength and for His mercy and for His love because I can't do it anymore if it weren't for Him. So if you were feeling down and out, I hope you're not now because we're in this together and it's called life. With Jesus. Praise his holy name. And I love you. Have a great day. I still don't have perfect, or I should say, reliable internet connection. So I'm still struggling with that. So anyways, God bless you. And email me. I'm so lonely now and I never hear from anybody. So it's winger.wanda@yahoo.com and adios, amigos. Bye bye.